Hello people and welcome to yet another episode of Sandmans Tackle Time. Tonight we're going to do one on the good old rotten bottom rig with an incorporated bait clip. By Christ, when we done that video on that rotten bottom rig, yous didn't half like that one. Must have hit the nail right on the head. Here's the little fella here. That's it there. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to incorporate a bait clip. It's very simple, very straightforward, but I'll incorporate a bait clip on it as quite a few of you have requested. Anyway, before I hear into that, I want to talk about pliers, again, as requested. I've noticed through the forum, as it's grown on a day-to-day basis, we're getting a lot of people having a go at making rotten bottom rigs, Gemini clips, fast links, etc, etc. And I think it's absolutely fantastic, as long as you're using the right stainless, people. Anyway, that's another story. But just before, let us say, just before we hear into this rotten bottom rig, I'd like to talk about pliers. Here is my range of pliers for what I use through making various things, as you can see, rotten bottom rigs and fast links and Gemini clips. I'm getting a bit low on these and various bits and bobs, but this here is what I use. I'm going to tell you where I've purchased them, what to keep away from, what's good, what's bad, what I use, and hopefully it'll help you. Right then. Where did it all start for me? Them little guys there. I bought a load of tools off a friend a long time ago, and this set of pliers here were in the box. I never thought anything of them or nothing like that until I saw a few lads making their own gear, and I thought, I can have a go at doing that. Cut a long story short, I started making Gemini clips, and bits and bobs with these. Anyway, they quickly become very uncomfortable. There's no handle on them. They never did have a handle on them. And I fancied something a little bit more easier on your hands, so to speak. I'd scouted about all over the place and I was struggling to find anything that was decent until I went into Halfords. And these are Halfords Professionals. I paid $9.99 for them, obviously from Halfords. And they've done the trick, absolutely brilliant. They're not really strong, but they do the job, and I've had very little trouble with them. But I've had these coming up about 2 or 3 years now, and they're starting to get a little bit tired. So I was in the pickle again. Where can I find a decent set of pliers? So I thought, well, I'll stick to what I know. If it isn't broke, don't fix it, so to speak. Went back to Halfords to try and buy another pair of these. For some unknown reason, discontinued, which is a big shame, because they were fantastic. For the sake of a tenner, I would have bought myself 2 or 3 pairs just to see us through. But like I say, you can't buy them anymore. Anyway, so one day we're driving past Machine Mart, and I thought, oh, Machine Mart, their pro version, they might do a decent circlip plier. Because at the end of the day, that's what they're called an external circlip plier. So I went and got these guys. I don't know if you can see the name there, but it actually says Clark. And I thought, oh, I'll be doing all right with these. They cost me, I think, about £7 with a VAT on. Pathetic. Absolutely. For what we do, absolutely no good at all. I haven't tried to chop them down. If I was to chop them down, take maybe a good inch off there, they might be okay. But the way they are at the moment, it was a shame. It was a lot of money wasted. So I went and recorded myself onto the good old eBay. And bumped into these guys, Draper. They were £11 and coppers, wherever they were, and I thought, well, I'll take a gamble, I really need a set. Draper hasn't got a bad name, I'll give them a try. So, sent away for them on eBay, 2 or 3 days later, sure enough, there they are, they landed. Best set of pliers I've ever worn. There they are there. So we can get these on eBay, lads, they're about £11 and coppers, wherever it is. Couple of days, they're there on your doorstep. They're that good, I went and bought myself another pair. And I've told several of my mates to go and buy themselves a pair who want to have a go at making their own tackle. They're really, really good. They really are good value for money. So there they are there. Draper on eBay. External circlip pliers. That's that. Anyway, so we'll put them to one side. Another good set of pliers that we use while making these bits and bobs of kit is a half decent set of long nose pliers. I've got loads of pairs of universal pliers, and these big boys are like the holy grail. These are NCB, National Coal Board pliers. They're still going strong, and I use this to cut the good old 316 grade. I don't use the jaws there, I actually use that bit there. As you can see, I'll put a piece of wire in so you can see it, and take it from me, very, very strong to say the least. So I use them to cut the 316 grade. Them guys there will cut the 8 and the 16 gauge. What I use, that's the 16 gauge there. What we're going to use to make a gate in a minute on this rotten bottom rig. They're okay for cutting that, but when it comes to the heavy duty stuff, I use them. Anyway, that's enough about me babbling on about pliers. So tonight, I'm going to do a rotten bottom rig. I know I've already done a rotten bottom rig on an episode of Sandmans Tackle Time, but I've never incorporated a bait clip in, and that's what we're going to do here tonight. Right then, so what do you need to do the job? Plunk that button there. Here I've got a piece of 316 grade, 8 centimetres long, stainless steel welding rod. That little guy there is 5 centimetres long, 16 gauge stainless steel. I'll just take the little lid off there so you can have a look at it. There it is there. Now please don't be fooled, this stuff here is not 18 gauge, this is 16 gauge, it's totally different, entirely different to 18 gauge. It's very strong for what it is, it's like a beefed up grip wire, so to speak. I use this for making, if I can find one, there's a one right there. There is a lightweight 5-link that I've got there. And there's another one. Now what I use these guys for, these ones here, I use them for the likes of the river. I would not be putting something like a 6 or 7 ounce sinker and doing the full pendulum, the high inertia or anything on them. If I was to do that, I'd be going to a fast link where I'd be using the 316 grade, the real heavy stuff for that. But for the likes of making your gates, that part there of your rotten bottom rig, that part there, the 16 gauge is absolutely fine with that. That is tried and tested, believe you me, by a lot of people. It is solid, absolutely solid. And we're going to use that tonight anyway. So, like I say, you want a piece of 316 grade stainless steel welding rod, 8 centimetres long, which is slightly longer than what we usually use, but we're going to incorporate a bait clip. 5 centimetres long, 16 gauge, or you can use 316 if you like, it's fine. There is a crow bead. Here I went to Dainty Supplies the other day. I'll just get you a handful out just so you can see them. There they are there. Crow beads. They were £1.10 for a packet of 100. So they really are. They're as cheap as chips. Dainty Supplies sell them up there in Washington, Crowther Industrial Estate. That's where I go. If you're stuck there, now and again, Asda sell them. And then after a fact, that Wilkins... Sorry, I'll take that back. Various... shops of Wilkinson's sell the crow beads, so with a bit of luck that'll help you on. Anyway, we'll just pop these back into there for the time being, and then I'll quickly hit onto this black cable, as you can see to my left. Now, as you can see on your rotten bottom rig, if you can just see, you've got a little piece of black sleeve. I've had a few guys asking me, Paul, what's that black sleeve? Where do you get it from? What's all that about? So here it is. This is 5-quart speaker cable, I believe, and I'm fortunate I have a very good electrical outlet shop very close to me down there in Horton. It's about 5 mile away, 4 mile away from where we live in Seam Harbour. There's a little shop there called Sawnell's. He's an electrical outlet. He's really good, he really is, and he sells this stuff. So what I do is I just get a hold of the end, strip it off, take out the copper in it. I end up with that. I cut that down to about, It's about a centimetre and a half, that. And that then goes onto there. And that there retails for 49 pence a metre. So get a fiver's worth. And honestly, it's limitless. I'll tell you now, if I was to get a big handful of these guys in there, I'll leave these out for a while. And there's more in there if you have a look. And this was off 5 metres. It really does, it goes on forever. So for a sake of a fiver, it's £5 well spent. Anyway, so we've got them out the way. We'll let them bide there. Right, here we go. I'm going to go and make this. Oh, quite briefly, before we go, all the bait clip is you'll have seen these before, relay clips. This one hasn't got a particular name on them, but I do believe that, I'm sure if I've got my story right, Breakaway come up with this idea. Cracking idea. There they are there. These can be purchased from a good bunch of retail angling shops, no problem at all. I happen to be in Andy Rutherford's today, and I purposely bought these because there was a lad actually asked us to do this program because he wanted to see an incorporated bait clip. These can be purchased from Andy Rutherford's, a lot of other tackle shops out there, North East Tackle and Fishing Republic, will probably sell all these, no problem at all. 99 pence for a packet of, what's that, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 99 pence for a packet of 10, so the cheapest chips. So what would I have done there is, I've popped it off, as you can see there. There's the one that I've got ready. Just get yourself a pair of nail clippers onto there and cut that off, and you end up with that, which is just the same as that, and that's all you do. And I'll show you where we're going to put that in a moment. Right then, so let's get down to making this rotten bottom. So get your good old trusted draper, if you like, external circuit pliers, and all we're going to do here is going to make a loop, as you've seen us do time and time and time again. Put your 316 grade into your pliers like that, so you're nice and flush, as you can see there. And what we're going to do is make a loop. So we're going to go around like that. We're going to make a loop. You're then getting to that stage there. Universal pliers you're going to use to close up that loop. Try and make your loop as neat and tidy as possible. It's the way I always do it. I think that a neat and tidy loop is probably a very good and strong loop. It looks nice. And there you go there. There's your loop. Another thing I'll just quickly hit on. When one fault I had with these pliers when I got it, I mean, you've seen there's quite a few rotten bottoms there. If you have a look on the corner of them pliers, they're quite sharp. As you can see, I don't know if you can make that out in the camera, but they're quite sharp. So what I done was, on my favourite edge, I just took a file and I just knocked the edge off with a file. And I must say, when it's sitting there in my thumb like that, it's a lot more, it's not as sharp, it doesn't feel like it's cutting into my thumb. So if you do get a pair of these, just have a, remember that corner, just a metal file, couple of guns over it, just knock the edge off a bit, feel a lot more comfortable in your hand. Anyway, so like you see, we've put the loop in. What we're going to do now is that these relay clips already come with a hole in, so what we're going to do is just twist it. As you can see, it's going through, there's no hole at the bottom. That goes through there, and that just simply pushes up. There's no rocket science in this at all. It's absolutely easy as out. So there we go now. There's your piece of 316, and there's your bait clip one. The next thing to go on is your piece of sheathing. There you go. And we'll just slide that up for the time being. That goes to there. The next thing to go on is your crow bead. That goes there. Now we're going to close this all up now, because we've finished putting bits and bobs on. So again, we're going to put another loop into the bottom. As you can see, I've butted it right up against the side of the ply there. As you can see, I've kept it right, nice and parallel, so it's all straight. And we're just going to come round and make a loop again. There you are. This time with the pliers, instead of closing the loop up, we're going to give it a little kink. Just like that. I'm going to leave that open. If you can just see me, make that out with the camera. We're going to leave that open. The reason that we're going to leave that open is because we'll put that down for the time being. And we're now going to use the 16 gauge to make the gate. So here we've got a piece of 5 centimetre long, 16 gauge stainless steel rods. What we're going to do now is get your round nose plier, go to the end, and you want to make a tiny, tiny little loop. As you can see, I've just come in from the tip there, maybe it's 2 mil. So you're getting it just like there. Grip that nice and tight, mind, so it doesn't slip. And just make a tiny, tiny little loop. There you go. And all you're going to do now is just nip that up. So you're there. Get your long nose pliers and place the gate into your long nose pliers like that, making sure that you've kept the gate nice and parallel to you. Grip nice and firm, and with your fingers, and bend that back to there. And that's what you've just made, that. Right then, so what we're going to do now is just quickly look at it. If it's slightly twisted, just get it into your plier and just straighten it up a bit. It was slightly out, but there, we've got it now. And what we'll do is we'll leave that there. We'll now pick up the main body of your rotten bottom rig. There's your gate, and we'll put that onto the bottom. We're now going to close up the rotten bottom rig at the bottom. We'll get that to there. And there we go. We'll put that into there. We'll get it just in the ply, because what you do is you just slightly kink it back a bit, just like that, as you can see. And there we go. We'll be able to make that out there. So that's fully closed up, ready to go. Now then, what we're going to do is we're going to get that black sheathing, and we're going to pull that black sheathing. Sorry, you probably can't see because of my hands. I'll move that black sheathing down right to the base, and that can go there. And then that goes there. Now what you want to do is get a hold of your gate, and you want to move it up. And what you want to do is just at the top, if I put that there, you see with a white background there, just at the top of where your black sheath is, you want to draw an imaginary line just to there. Now watch. So you've got it like that. Put your finger where the imaginary line is. Put your plies onto that. Make sure that your part of your loop there is facing directly at you. Get your thumb and just bend that back a bit. That's what you've done. I'll just try and keep it there so you can see. I've bent that back a bit. So now you can see it's starting to run parallel with the shaft, but it's a little bit too long. So we're just going to trim a little bit of that up. And as you can see now, it now runs, I know it's a bit rough, but I'm trying to get you so you can see this at home. It now runs absolutely great with the side of your sheath. Your bead would then pop down, and that's it, you're ready to rock and roll. Now then, for those that's never seen a rotten bottom rig, if you just bear with us a moment, I'll get you a seat there. I know what I'm about to do is a waste of time to a lot of this, because there's hundreds and hundreds of thousands of people out there know how these rotten bottoms work and the rest of it. But this is just for the lads that's never seen these before, and they don't know how they work, and they're thinking, like, I understand what they're saying, but I don't fully understand how it works. So this is for you. What you do is, I've getting thick line here. The reason I've done that is just for photographic purposes, so you can see it a lot better, lads. That's all that's about. I'll move them out of the way. What you would do here, the whole purpose of a rotten bottom is a weak link. That's what you're doing. You're fishing heavy ground, whether it be rocky, kelp, whatever you're doing, you're fishing heavy ground. You're willing to sacrifice your sinker. That's basically what you're doing to make sure you get that big fish in. So imagine that this is 10-pound line. The maximum I would ever go to, me personally, is probably 12. 15 at a push, but I don't really like to use 15, so a 10-12 pound line is what I would use. So there's your sinker, and all I'm going to do is a standard half blood, 1, 2, 3 through the bottom. I'm not going to bother with gob oil or nothing like that, because I'm just simply making a knot. So there you go. Keep in mind that this isn't really 70 pound blue marlin, it's only 12 pound, shall we say. Trim that down a little bit. Then you would go to the bottom of your rotten bottom rig and you would tie that onto there using a half blow door, whatever knot you choose to use. Anyway, I've got that there. I'm just doing this quickly to see if I move that. So you're now there. So what you can do is you get your gate and you put the gate through the eye of the sinker, like so. Your gate would come round and the bead comes over there and sits like that. And the theory is, you cast out, as the sinker enters the water, the force of the pressure, the force of the water passing past the bead knocks it off like that. And because I'm only using a small sinker, if it was a normal one, that would drop off and you would then be under a weak link, as you can see there. Obviously that sinker got fast, you would pull and pull, with that only being 10 to 12 pound line, that would snap and you would get your gear back and hopefully that big fish that you've always dreamt of. So let's quickly just trim that off. So there you go, boys and girls. There is your rotten bottom rig with incorporated bait clip. Very simple, very cheap to do, and very effective. I've never had one fail on us. I've heard a couple of lads say maybe in extreme cold temperatures it would snap. What if it did? Mack another one. They're not the end of the world, are they? So you'll be alright in that. Anyway, that was short and sweet. So that's the end of another Sandmans Tackle Time. So you take care out there, be safe, and I'll see you all on the next episode of Sandmans Tackle Time. Bye bye.